वेलकम टू ब्रिज कोर्स समग्र शिक्षा सिद्धिपेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स लेवल 3 फॉर 6th 7th एंड 8th क्लासेस। दिस इज G1 SA मैथमेटिक्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन टू अलजेब्रा। लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस टॉपिक you will be able to define a variable and make an algebraic rule for given daily life situation. Let's know what is algebra. Algebra is a part of mathematics. In this, we use letters or alphabets to represent numbers. These letters can represent any number, not just a particular number. It is an unknown quantity and it is called a variable. Now, let's know what is a variable. Let's observe some situations to understand the concept of the variable. See here, below tabular form shows the weights of the students in a classroom. That is, Krishna weight is 32 kg, Lakshman weight is 33 kg, Ganesh 29 kg, Ramu 30 kg, Kartikeya 35 kg, Shiva 37 kg. In this table, the first column shows the name of the student. It may be any student. That means there is no particular student. So, as we don't know the name of the student, we can't tell the weight of the student. If we know the name, we can tell the weight. So, we represent the weight of the unknown person or student by unknown quantity, that is letter X. This letter X is called the variable. So, it may be any number. Usually, we write this table like this. Let's observe another table. It shows the cost of the vegetables in a market. That is, cost of onions 25 rupees per 1 kg, potato 40 rupees, tomato 15 rupees, brinjal 36 rupees, lady's finger 38 rupees, cluster bean 48 rupees and carrot 60 rupees. Here also, the first column shows the name of the vegetable. It may be any vegetable. There is no particular vegetable to know the cost. So, as we don't know the name of the vegetable, we can't tell the cost of the vegetable. So, we represent the cost of the unknown vegetable with Y. This is called the variable. The form can be written like this. Now, let's observe some patterns to understand the variable. To make one triangle, we know that 3 matchsticks are needed and to make 2 triangles 6 matchsticks are needed. And also to make 3 triangles 9 matchsticks are needed. Here we can form a table for this data. Observe, this first column shows the number of matchsticks required for one triangle. Second column shows number of triangles, and third column represents total number of matchsticks. Observe here, in this first row, 3 is number of triangles to make one triangle, and 1 is number of triangles, 3 is total number of matchsticks required. Also, to make 2 triangles, 6 matchsticks are required. To make 3 triangles, 9 matchsticks are needed. In this first row, we can write 3 into 1 is equal to 3. In the second row, 3 into 2 is equal to 6. In the third row, 3 into 3 equal to 9. In this last row, to make m triangles, we can write 3 into m is equal to 3m matchsticks are needed. So we can write number of matchsticks required is equal to 3 into number of triangles to be formed. So here m represents the number of triangles. This is called the rule to make triangles. So m is called the variable. Students, I hope all of you understand the concept of variable and the rules. So now try to answer this question and discuss with your friends. Thank you for watching.